beginnings, yes. There are two beginnings that I would speak of. It's going to be very brief because I haven't had much time to think about it. I would sing songs with the Callan host, but I never actually led many or any of them. And I would tell stories, but I would tell stories in the post-battle to a couple of people standing nearby. I never stood up even in a bar circle and told wherein I was going to send them on stage, big hall. They weren't a ton of people, sure, but a lot of people. And the stage was huge, and I felt very small. And so I got out there to tell my story. But I had told it many times in the story. And I gave it my best shot. It was a bill of my own construction. And when I came down, had I known that I was the master of the world, now barred of the office, I would have been just so frightful. But he came up, and Owen congratulated me on a good potato, and I was so happy. And then a young lady came up, and she told me that stories such as I had told are important to tell of the legends and those who came before and have done so much for our society. And then she gave me the greatest gift I will ever receive. She took from her belt a favor given to her by her beloved princess, Elishaba. It was a favor with a golden woven heart and the North Shield star, and said, I want you to have this, and then if someone inspires you, to pass it on. And so Elian gave me that gift. It was the first and of many tokens and other lauds that I would get, but I will always, always treasure that moment. And I did begin to pass it on, and Kirian has had that. The gentleman who wrote Road to Rome had it for a time. Lucia has had it. Other people that you've heard of in the society who I now cannot remember because I am now getting nervous. But I just wanted to come up and let you know that though it may seem like even a little thing, the gestures that you give can echo like dropping a stone into a still pool, the ripples will spread.